A very good afternoon to all of you. Today I'm going to take up a grammar lesson, and that is direct and indirect speech. Before I come on to the main part, I would just like to highlight the importance of helping verbs. Okay, the first three sentences that I have written on the board, the first one is, my mother is baking a cake. Now the main verb is baking. The main verb is baking. But there is another word that is qualifying the baking, and that is baking a cake. The second sentence is, my mother was baking a cake. This is for the same thing. The third sentence that I have is, my mother will be baking a cake. Now, the importance, or the main verb is baking, because I've taken the same similar sentence. Now, these words are very, very important, is, was, will be. Why are they important? Because these helping verbs, they tell us the tense that has been used in the sentence. Now, my mother is baking a cake. Now, this is in the present, okay? Present tense. Was baking a cake, past tense. Okay. Will be baking a cake, future. So it's very, very important to know that these are helping verbs, and they help the main verb, they qualify the main verb, and they tell us the tense of the sentence. Now we move on to the main part. Now, in direct and indirect speech, we have the teacher said, then we have a comma, then we have inverted commas open, and the first letter is in capital, if you see, and the class has done well, full stop, inverted commas, close, okay? Now, this portion, the teacher said, this said, is the reporting verb. This is very, very important in direct and indirect. It is called the reporting verb. Very important, reporting verb. Okay, now here we see the teacher said, and this part, which is in inverted commas, that is supposed to be the direct speech of the person who has said these words, who has spoken these words. Okay, so the teacher has spoken these words, and the exact words are there in inverted commas here. So this is the reported speech. This is the narration. This is the reported speech. Now when we have to highlight, when we rewrite this, I will write down, the teacher said that the class had done well. Okay. Now, look at the sentence here. The teacher said, and then we have the reported speech here. Now, this was direct speech. Okay. Now, we have converted it to indirect speech. So, the commas have all gone up. Okay. And we have connected these two sentences with this word that. Okay, we have connected the sentences, we have made it into one sentence, and we have combined it with the word that. Another change that you must have noticed is, here it was, the class has done well. Here I have written, the class had done well. Now this is because whatever was said in the present, now we are repeating it, but we are changing the tense. Now, why are we changing the tense here? This was present tense, but here we have changed it to past tense. Now, this is because the teacher said. Now, said is the reporting verb. Very, very important. Okay. The entire changes that will come in the second part of the sentence, that will be done on the basis of your reporting verb. Okay. So this is in the past tense. Present is say or says. Okay. So here the reporting verb is in the past tense, said. And then we connected it with that the class had done well. So when the reporting verb is in the past tense, the tense here will also change, okay? From to like simple present, it will change to simple past. So because of has, we have now changed it to had, because the reporting verb is in the past tense, that is said. Now look at the second sentence, B sentence. The teacher said, comma, inverted commas open. This is the speech that is quoted. This is the quoted speech. We also call it quoted speech. Q-U-O-T-E-D, quoted speech. The earth is round. Now I'm going to rewrite it. The teacher said that the earth is round. Now, I've just said that if the reporting verb is in the past tense, then this also has to change. But here you will notice that the is there in this sentence also, and is there in the second sentence also, the one which has been rewritten into indirect speech. The teacher said that the earth is round. Now, why this is an exception when we this reporting verb said, there is an exception. And what is that? When there is a universal fact in question or in the picture, then we cannot change it to the past tense. Because if I change it to the past tense, it will become the teacher said that the earth was round, because is, the past tense of is will become was. So, but I cannot use that here and say that means the earth was round, but now it is not round. Now, this is a universal fact that the earth is round. So, remember that when the reporting verb is in the past tense, the tense in the following part of the sentence will also change to the past tense, okay? But when the reporting verb is in the past tense and there is a universal fact or a reality or a truth, for example, the teacher said, honesty is the best policy. Okay, so here again, I will say the teacher said that honesty is the best policy, because that is a fact, okay, that cannot change. So I will not make it to honesty was the best policy. So this exception you have to remember, that even if the reporting verb said is in the past tense, the tense of the helping verb here will not change to the past tense. Okay, that's one exception. The third sentence I had written, the teacher said to me, comma, inverted commas open, the class is very quiet. Now, this sentence I've written to tell you that when you have something like this in the sentence, said to me, here it was only said, and we connected it with that and we combined the sentence. But when we have the teacher said to me, there is a little, small little, slight change, and that will be the teacher told me. Said to me becomes, sorry, said to me becomes told me. Okay, and then we combine it. That the class was very quiet. Okay, the teacher said to me, this said is in the past tense. That is why this is has changed to was. But the only difference is said to me, you will rewrite it as told me. Because somebody has said something to you, that means somebody has told you. So when you are rewriting it as indirect speech, you will say the teacher told me that the class was very quiet. Okay. Now, this was simple. Okay. So the basic actually was this. Now, as we said, present tense, past tense, future tense. These are the main three tenses, of course, and we have others with them, you know, present continuous tense and past continuous tense, then present perfect and all those, okay? But the main ones are present, past and future. Now here, this A, this big one that I have taken, the teacher says. Here I had written said, so that is the past tense. This is the reporting verb. In this sentence, the reporting verb is in the present tense. Says is in the present tense. Now, what happens when the reporting verb is in the present tense? The helping verb here will not change to the past. When the reporting verb is in the present tense, there is no change in the verb ahead. Okay, you have to bear that in mind. It's a rule. Okay, when the reporting verb is in the past tense, then the verb here also changes. There will be a change here. But when the reporting verb is in the present tense, like says, there will be no change here. So how will I rewrite it? The teacher says that the teacher says that the class has done well. Says that the class has done well. Not had done well. Okay. So this we will not change. So remember, when the reporting verb is in the present tense, the helping verb here will not change to the past tense. Similarly, the B sentence that I have, the teacher will say. Now here we said this was past tense, says was present tense, and will say is future. That is future tense. Okay, future tense. Now, the teacher will say the class has done well. Again here, the same rule is repeated as we repeated for present tense. When the reporting verb is in the future tense, no change is made in this sentence over here. No change is made. The sentence is rewritten combining with that, and it is rewritten. This verb here will not change. So what will it be? The teacher will say that the class has done well. Same sentence, okay? So, repeat. When the reporting verb is in the past tense, the verbs here will also change according to the sentence, okay? Then, when it is a universal fact but the reporting verb is said, past tense, this will not change because it's a universal fact. Then here I wrote said to tell you, said to me, that changes to told, okay? Then when this reporting verb is in the present tense, there is no change in the rest of the sentence. You just combine it with that. Even when the reporting verb is in the future tense, there will be no change in the other part of the sentence. So it's very, very important to highlight and see first what the reporting verb is, okay? And then you proceed, with the changing, okay? So this is quoted speech, direct speech. This is direct speech, quoted speech. The sentences here down, which I have rewritten by changing. Now, this is indirect speech. Okay, indirect speech. All the commas, all inverted commas, all commas have gone. Now, you can get the sentences in both ways. Either you can get this, change them into indirect speech, or you get a sentence like this, change them into direct speech. For example, if you get a sentence, the teacher told me that the class was very quiet. Now here, if you are asked to change, then because it was told, so you know said to me will come. The teacher said to me, comma. You have to separate the main part of the speech by a comma. Then you begin with inverted commas, and the first letter of the word will be in capital letters. You end with a full stop, and then you end with inverted commas. Okay. So this was just the initial part of how to begin with direct and indirect. Then we will go on. So just remember, these helping verbs are very, very important, okay? Because they define the tense of the sentence. And that is what you have to look. Said, past tense. Said, past tense, but universal fact. So it cannot be changed. You have to remember the sentence will be rewritten as it is. All right. So we continue. There are certain rules for changing sentences from direct to indirect. So we begin with rule number one, change of pronouns. Okay. Now, as you know, just let me refresh you all with this. We are talking about first person, second person, and third person pronouns that we're talking about. First person is the person who is speaking. Second person is the person spoken to. And third person is the person spoken about. For example, first person in a singular form, if you say I, me, my. And when we talk in terms of plural, then it is we, ours, us. Okay? Now, so that is the first rule for the first person pronouns. Okay? The first person pronouns, I, me, my, we, ours, us, they are changed with the subject of the reporting speech. Changed with the subject. Okay? Now, we go on with the first sentence and I'll explain it to you how. He said to me, I am a good boy. Okay. Now, this is the subject. And over here, we just take the first part of the sentence. This is the subject and me is the object. He is the subject and me is the object over here. And here we have the personal first person pronoun. So when we rewrite the sentence, how will we write it? First said to me, as I've told you, he told me that. What is the subject? He. So this I over here will change to he. He. Am is present tense, okay, but this is said, so it will be he was a good boy. So all the first person pronouns like I, me, my, we, ours, us, they are changed with the subject of the reporting speech. Now, this much is the reporting speech because this is the reporting verb, okay, so this is very important. So the subject here in this part of the sentence is he, and the object is me. And then this is the exact quoted words, the I am a good boy. So he said to me, he told me that he was a good boy. So you just have to look at the subject here and you will know that you have to bring it here. But for that, you just have to remember that first person pronouns, okay, which are the first person pronouns, then it becomes easy. For singular form, it is I, me, my, and for plural forms, it is we, ours, us, okay. Now, the second sentence, they said, we are going to school, okay, they said, we are going to school. Now, here we will write, they said, okay, they said. That now comes, now you have to apply the rule. So what is the subject in the reported speech here? They. They is the subject. Like he was the subject over here. They is the subject over here. Okay? So they said that, so this we will change to they. They said that they are going to, they said that they were going to school. It's just simple, children. Nothing to get worked up about. And how will we do it? No, it's very, very simple. Where we have to change these, you know, first person pronouns like I is over here or we is over here, then we get confused and now what will we put? So the answer lies in the sentence for you. It's as simple as that. He said to me, I am a good boy. So the subject in this part of the reporting speech is he and the object is me, of course. And here, I am a good boy. So this I will change to the subject that is given in the sentence, that is he. So he said to me becomes told. He told me that he was a good boy. Now because said is in the past tense, so am, which was the present tense, it will change to past tense. As simple as that. Here we have second sentence. They said, and what the subject is they in this part of the sentence. They said, said reporting verb is in the past tense. They said, we are going to school. So we have to combine it. They said that. Now we will change according to the subject that is given here. Okay. Because we is a first person pronoun. Okay. So they were going to school. Are, which is present tense, it'll change to were, which is past tense. So just remember, simple rule is that the first person pronouns, I, me, my, we, ours, us, which is given in inverted commas or given in the second part of the sentence, they will be changed according to the subject which is given in the reporting speech. Okay, reported speech. Is that clear? So your answer lies in the sentence itself. There's no need, there's no question, you know, of you all making a mistake. But this is for the first person. Now we come on to rule two. Rule two says that second person pronouns. Now which one is the second person pronouns? You and yours. Okay. The person spoken to. You, yours. They are changed with the object of the reporting speech. Just as this was the reporting speech, we said that we will change these pronouns according to the subject. Rule 2 says that the second person pronouns, you, yours, they will change with the object of the reporting speech. With the object, not the subject. So that is why I have written over here, he is the subject and me is the object. Okay, so let's see with rule 2 how we can change this. He said to us, you are wasting your time. Okay, now he is the subject over here. Us is the object over here. So this you, second person pronoun will be changed according to the object now. This is the rule number 2. So he said to us, now said to becomes told. So it will be, he told us that, he told us that, now what will be, us is the object. So us means we, okay. He told us that we were wasting our time. Okay, object is us. Us means we. Okay, object is us and us means we. So this you will change to we. Now when we are making ourselves we, automatically the are first changes to were because said is in the past tense. So present tense are will change to past tense were. And wasting your time will become our time because we are using the word we. We were wasting our time. So this us is the object. So that is how we change. Let's go on to the second sentence to repeat it once again. She said to me, you are going to my house. She said to me. Now who is me? She is the subject, that's clear. Who, me is the object. And otherwise, if I say who's me, me is I. Me is I. So when we rewrite the sentence, let's see how it goes on. We will write, she said to me means, She told me that, me becomes I, that I, you are going to my house, that I was going to her house. Okay, she told me that, that she said to me, you are going to my house. Okay, so she said to me, me is the object. So this will change, this you will change according to the object. So she told me that I, R has to be changed. I was going to my house, means her house. Okay, that I was going to her house. Okay, so it's as simple as that. Rule 3, third person pronouns. Third person pronouns are he, she, it. Okay, so of the reported speech remains unchanged. It remains unchanged. So easy for you. Okay, now let's see. Third person pronouns he, she, it of the reported speech remains unchanged. He will say to me, he will go home. He will say to me, he will go home. So say to me becomes, said to me was told. So say to me will be tell. So what will we write? He will tell me that. Me means I. That I will go home. Okay? He will say to me, sorry, not he will say to me. He will tell me that I, he will say to me becomes tell. He will tell me that he will go home. Because he over here, subject, okay? So no change. She said to me it is raining. She said means she told me that. She told me that. It was raining. She told me that it was raining. Okay. So she said to me, she told me remains the same thing. It that was here remains same. That it was raining. So third person pronouns, it or she or he, they will not change. Okay, that is what we have. He will say to me, he will go home. He will tell me that he will go home. This he has not changed. Okay, this it has not changed. Okay, so very, very simple. Nothing to get very unnerved. Just remember, first person, second person, third person. First person is the speaker. I, me, my, we, ours, us. Okay. These first person pronouns will change with the subject of the reporting speech. Now, this is the reporting speech. He said to me, they said, he said to us, she said to me. This is all, the first part is the reporting speech. So, the first person pronouns are changed according to the subject. So, when you have these first person pronouns, you just have to look at the subject and then this first pronoun will change to the according to the subject. Like this, I was there, the subject is he. So, when we are changing it, you just have to change that I to he. Okay? And accordingly, you will change the rest. Like, and the present tense will of course change to past tense. Now, same thing over here. They said, we are going. Now this we has to be changed because we have to change this part of the sentence. So the subject has they. So when we are writing this, we will change to they. They said that they were going to school. As simple as that. You just have to look at the subject and accordingly this will change. Now for the second person pronouns, that is you and yours, they are changed with the object of the reporting speech, not the subject. Here the subject, here they are changed according to the object. He said to us, us is the object, okay. So when you have to change this you, you have to change it to us. And what does us mean? We. So this you changes to we, okay. She said to me, you are going to my house. Now what is the object? Object is here me. Me means I. So automatically you get I. In the third person in the third person pronouns, that's rule 3, he, she, it of the reported speech remains unchanged. Okay? He will say to me, he will go home. He will tell me that he will go home. No change at all. They will remain as it is, the third person pronouns. So whatever you have after the inverted commas, that will remain as it is. No change. Okay. So that is rule 1, rule 2, and rule 3 for the personal pronouns. The first person, second person, and third person pronouns. So these helping verbs which give us the tense, they are very, very important. Very, very important. So for the time being, I think this is enough. The second part on the changes, the major changes that are brought about in the words, also in the sentences, also the other rules, that I will continue in part 2 of direct and indirect. So thank you very much for watching. God bless you all.